Hello, what's up? Gleb Alexandrov here for CreativeShrimp.com. It is hilarious. I think I have just photoscanned a nebula. Of course, it's not a real nebula, it's the one rendered in 3D software, in Blender for that matter, visualized as 3D Gaussian splats, which is a fairly new technology in the field of photogrammetry. You know, historically, it has been impossible to capture the volumetric substances like this by the means of photogrammetry, and here we go! Here it is, running in real time, right in your browser, or in the app. That is crazy. Basically, what I did was, first I captured a bunch of photos, or rather, renders of this Inky Nebula from our Nebula course, just like you capture a regular photo scan, but instead of taking photos, I took renders. To speed up the process, each camera position was keyframed to set all frames rendering all at once. The sample count in cycles was jacked up to very high quality indeed to suppress the noise, and it was very important that the resolution was at least 1080p. Using noise reduction wouldn't help here, as it would drive the scanning software crazy. I've got a few unsuccessful attempts before it worked, so I know. So, I left it rendering overnight, and got this nice folder of overlapping camera angles, around 170 of them. What a waste of time, I thought. The photo scanning applications won't recognize this object anyway. But I proceeded. To reconstruct the Gaussian splats, I used three tools, two web-based and one pretty complex Windows setup, and each eventually worked, which is completely off the charts. The first thing I did was just zipping the photos, or rather the renders, and sending it over to Luma Labs. Here you can see that I've had a few failed attempts, but basically here we go, a Gaussian splatting of the 3D nebula which didn't even have a solid surface to begin with. It turned up wrapped in a black cloud, which looked like a donut of darkness. It even has a hole in it in the center, which is kind of impressive on its own. But yeah, I wonder if you agree, I think it is a fairly impressive result all in all. Then I tried the same thing, but with the Polycam web app. And again, to show the process really quickly, what we need is no more than 150 photos for the free version, if I remember correctly. All we need to do is drag it into the Polycam web UI, call it somehow, and let it run the calculation process. Then it should spit out the 3D Gaussians eventually, if all goes well. Here my result also turned up submerged or surrounded by the creeping darkness VFX, but actually it seems like a pretty cool way to store and visualize the volume data. Seems pretty efficient to me, actually. Taking just a few megabytes of space, having a decent performance, running in real time, and having a decent detail as well. I think we're onto something here, with all these Gaussian splats. Finally, I've used the open source 3D Gaussian splatting setup by Inria, that John Stevens, aka the Nerf Guru, kindly explained how to use in the Getting Started with 3D Gaussian Splatting for Windows beginner tutorial on YouTube, with all the software dependencies and the instructions available on the GitHub page that John has created. I'll share the link in the description. I won't go into the weeds right now, let's just say that it requires a pretty powerful NVIDIA GPU. John recommends the one with at least 24 GB of video memory, but my 2080 Ti has 12, and I'm sure it would work on a much less powerful GPU as well, this example at least. So I downloaded and installed all the software dependencies from that GitHub page, again I'll share it as a link in the description, trained the neural network, etc. Long story short, the result ended up even better, a higher quality Gaussian splatting than the one used in the web tools. Although, of course, harder to set up and all that stuff. Anyway, that was the result, and it completely blew my mind. I think it's simply fantastic. Like, look at that. Still, I can't believe it is possible to photoscan ethereal substances like these, which don't have a solid surface. A few months ago, it would be a lost cause trying to pull it off via the traditional photogrammetry software. And here we go. So, is this interesting? Is this something that you think may change the process of how we export and view the volumetric data? It can be imported into game engines too, for that matter, and I'm sure that someone will write a plugin for Blender at some point. I hope it was interesting to you. If you liked this video, feel free to press like and subscribe to this channel, that would be much appreciated indeed. And if you want to learn more about how to create the nebulae like this in Blender, make sure to check our Nebula course. which is available on Blend Market and Gumroad. The whole process is covered there in a lot of detail. My name is Gleb Alexandrov. Drink more coffee and we will change the world of computer graphics.